we need to first set the stage. What was the Indian astronomical model? The model was one of nakshatras and rashi. Our ancient Indians, they divided the sky into several segments of 13 and 1/3 degree segments. They started from the eastern horizon and they said that let me divide the first 13 and 1/3 into the first nakshatra, the next 13 and 1/3 second nakshatra, third into the third nakshatra, all the way to the western horizon. But they didn't stop there. If this was the night sky, they knew this was the day sky, that side. They divided that portion also of the sky into 13 and 1/3 degree segments and they formed 27 of them. These are the 27 nakshatras. If you multiply 27 by 13 and 1/3, you'll get 360 degrees, the full 360 degrees. Now, it is not enough to divide it into nakshatras. You must also be able to recognize that tomorrow. So what they did was that first 13 and 1/3, they said, what is the brightest star in that segment of the sky? That brightest star, for example, it might have been Aldebaran. Aldebaran is the Arabic name. The Indian name is Rohini. So they said, because Rohini is there, I'm going to call it Rohini nakshatra. The next segment may be the brightest star or Spica. Spica is the star which in India we call Chitra, Chitra nakshatra. Next, we have perhaps Zeta Piscium. Zeta Piscium is Revati nakshatra. So this way, every nakshatra was identified by the principal brightest stars present in that segment of the sky and identified accordingly. So those are the 27 nakshatras that you see in this outer circle over here. They straddle the month. What you see over here is the nakshatra, Chitra, and below that is a Chaitra Masa. So when the full moon appears over the Chitra nakshatra, that month is a Chaitra month. That is how ancient Indians observed months and so on. Similarly, for Falguni, the Falguna Masa, Magha, in other words. They also divided the sky in 30 degree segments called the Rashi, and these are all the familiar Rashis that we know. So here is a listing of all the nakshatras in two of our ancient books, the Vedanga Jyotisha and the Surya Siddhanta. Vedanga Jyotisha is conservatively dated to 1400 BCE because of the phenomena contained therein. So that has got a listing of all the nakshatras, and these are those nakshatras. Surya Siddhanta is conservatively dated to 700 BCE or 400 current era. Take your pick. There's a lot of controversy over there. And they too contain a list of nakshatras that seem to match each other. And here are the principal stars. Kritika is Eta Tauri, Rohini is Alpha Tauri, Mrigashira is Lambda Orionis, and so on, all the way to Revati, Zeta Piscium, and so on.